Graduates and guests, our ceremony will begin in 10 minutes. Please find your seats at this time. Use the QR code on the scoreboard to access the graduate recognition booklet. And look for your graduate on the jumbotrons as they emerge from the tunnels and walk onto the graduate platforms. But now, please direct your attention to the right outfield tunnel, because here come the Angel Strike Force with t-shirts and our CSULB mascot, LB. Graduates and guests, our ceremony will begin in just a couple of moments. Please take your seats at this time. Remember to use our QR code on the scoreboard to access the graduate recognition booklet, and watch for your graduate to appear on the jumbotrons as they walk across the graduate platforms.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Graduates and guests, joining us today to recognize and honor our graduating class of 2023 are distinguished guests and leaders from our college and university. Emmer Williams, Grand Marshal, Chair of Kinesiology. Kylie Godey, 2023 Outstanding Graduate. Kurt Brower, President, COCLB Alumni Council. Erliana Erliana, Chair of Healthcare Administration. Kamiar Alay, Chair of Health Science. Michael Williams, Director of Nursing. George Benick, Chair of Physical Therapy. Adam Butts, Chair of Public Policy and Administration. Peifang Hong, Chair of Speech Language Pathology. Grace Reynolds Fisher, Associate Dean. Tiffany Vargas, Associate Dean. Monica Lounsbury, Dean of the College of Health and Human Services. Jody Cormack, Vice Provost and Dean of Graduate Studies. Jeffrey D. Cook, Chief Communications Officer. Chris Fowler, Chief of Staff. Min Yao, Vice President, Information Technology. Daniel Montoya, Vice President, University Relations and Development. Scott Appel, Vice President, Administration and Finance. Beth Lesson, Vice President, Student Affairs. Karen Sism Gunn, Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs. Jane Close Connolly, President, California State University, Long Beach. In 2018, the university adopted a new alma mater, with lyrics by Christian Valdez and music by Kyle Gabriel, composed when both were students in the Bob Cole Conservatory of Music. To sing it for you today, please welcome Natalie Gonzalez, also a graduate of the Bob Cole Conservatory of Music.
President Conley, honored guests, alumni, faculty, staff, graduates, and friends and families of our graduates, welcome to the class of 2023 Commencement. As Dean of the College of Health and Human Services, it is my distinct honor to welcome you to the 74th commencement of the California State University, Long Beach. The graduates we honor here today have earned degrees from more than 70 degree programs within the College of Health and Human Services, and thus, they will join a special part of the workforce that will have direct implications for helping people live happier, healthier, and safer lives. Congratulations to you, class of 2023. Each year, a faculty member is selected to serve as Grand Marshal for the commencement ceremony. This year, the high honor is given to Dr. Emmer Williams, professor and chair in the Department of Kinesiology. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Williams. Ah, there you are. Thank you very much. Congratulations, class of 2023. You made it, and we at the university could not be more pleased for you. For many of you, you are the first in your family to obtain the degree you're receiving today. And for some of you, it has been a lifelong dream to be at this ceremony, celebrating this monumental achievement. No matter what your specific circumstances are, I am sure that for you, obtaining the degree you are earning today was a decision that was made. It was a matter of innumerable sacrifices and the will to persevere time and time again, and you didn't do it alone. So, it is fitting that we start our ceremony with giving gratitude. Graduates, please stand. Wave to your friends and family and faculty who supported you. And now raise your voice in gratitude and celebration. Please be seated. Each year we set out to talk with members of our graduating class to learn more about them and what they have accomplished. These stories are ones of transformation, agency, and perseverance, of which are all truly inspiring. Let me share a few of these stories with you. From the Department of Healthcare Administration, international student Ni Yun told us that her degree program taught her how to communicate with others, solve problems, and adapt to different situations, all while being part of a team. Jennifer Santos, also completing her degree in healthcare administration, told us about the importance of taking inventory of personal priorities on the road to achieving success. After deep reflection, Jennifer changed her major after realizing her greatest strengths and her strong desire to help other people live happier, healthier, and safer lives. She told us that in the future, she hopes to serve her community by creating better workplaces within the healthcare industry. From the Department of Health Science, Anna Karen Gonzalez hopes to use her degree in community health education to pursue an advanced degree in the medical field. Her dream is to become a healthcare provider to reduce disparities existing in community and public health. Likewise, Jocelyn Pena hopes to enter the nonprofit sector upon graduating. The community and school health education graduate has a motto, "Querer es poder," meaning Where there is a will, there is a way. Jocelyn says that this affirmation has impacted her life by giving her motivation to continue the fight and used it throughout her college experience when school or life got hard. Her aim is to make a difference in the field of health science. As well, Abhishek Kharki decided to come to Cal State Long Beach to pursue a health science degree so that he could take what he learned back to serve his community in his home country of Nepal. In turn, Mariana Carrillo's dream is to use her community health degree to provide services and advocacy for better mental health programs. We were especially touched to learn the story of Brianna Sions, who also obtained her degree in community health. In addition to taking on a full course load and working as a research assistant in the Center for Latino Community Health, Brianna is a full-time caregiver to her 7-year-old daughter, who is medically disabled with a rare genetic disorder that requires constant care. That hasn't stopped Brianna from pursuing her education. Brianna recalls many instances sitting in the hospital rooms waiting to hear about the latest health updates from doctors and nurses about her daughter, while simultaneously trying to study or even having to take a final for a class. Even with the obstacles I faced at home, I still managed to make it this far, Brianna says of her graduation today. Some of our graduates told us of their transformation. From the Department of Kinesiology, Daniel Bello shared his story of overcoming imposter syndrome to obtain his sports psychology degree. He said, "I had doubts throughout my education, the biggest obstacle to overcome being myself. Recognizing that I do belong made me start to believe in my potential. I found the confidence to become more involved on campus and started to meet other students away from the classroom. Hearing about their experiences and building important connections made me feel supported by the university." Many of our graduates will go into fields where they will support and care for others, like Diala Elkazen and Randy Nguyen, who will use their sports psychology and athletic training degrees, respectively, to provide health and wellness support to athletes as personal trainers. The support and care of others truly rings true for our physical therapy, school of nursing, and speech language pathology graduates. From the Department of Physical Therapy, the Doctor of Physical Therapy Class 23 is one that has dealt with a lot of adversity during their time at Long Beach State, as many of you have. Like most graduating students today, they started during the height of the pandemic and they had to deal with faculty and staff rearranging courses and labs in order to meet COVID restrictions. Our DPT students did this with a smile on their face, or at least we expect a smile under the mask and face shield. They were a large part of reopening our classes and took it all in stride. Fast forward to this past February, where our PT students got to present their research projects in San Diego at the largest physical therapy conference in the country. Through it all, they have been very positive, facing the many challenges that came their way. This will only help them excel their future careers as physical therapists and will likely be leaders wherever they go. From the School of Nursing, Rayanne Chung shared her dream of using her specialization in gerontology to be a leader in her nursing field to help older adults. As well, Maya Early chose to go into nursing due to her love for the profession and her experience as a patient. Born prematurely with her twin sister, Maya credits the help of nurses in the neonatal intensive care unit for saving her and her sister's lives. "I have always felt the need to give back to the nursing profession, becoming a nurse myself. I hope to make others feel that someone is advocating for them during difficult times, Maya said. Another nursing student, Christina Soyasu, describes her difficult time of completing her ICU rotations while also dealing with the sudden passing of her father. Amazingly, Christina still maintained her 4.0 GPA through that time and graduates today in honor of her father. Christina credits the encouragement and collective empathy she experienced from her School of Nursing peers, faculty, and staff, which helped her to overcome the challenges she experienced while a student. She hopes to provide that same encouragement to her nursing patients upon graduation. Emily Tran was also inspired to become a nurse. Through seeing how nurses took care of her grandfather when he was diagnosed with liver cancer, Emily told us that seeing how nurses cared for him and my family was unbelievable and so selfless. I want to be able to serve my community through my practice, building relationships with my patients, and ensuring that their needs are met. From the Department of Speech-Language Pathology, Amy Takamoto shared her experience working with her clients in speech-language clinic and her school-based and hospital-based internships. Amy told us, "During my time at CSULB, I've learned the importance of advocacy and collaboration with professors, supervisors, peers, and other allied professionals and clients, as well as a commitment to providing effective and efficient services to improve individuals' overall quality of life. My experiences also taught me to never underestimate a client's capacity to improve." Similarly, Michaela Lashley is excited to use her speech-language pathology degree to help pioneer a research-based charge for underserved populations in her community who struggle with communication disorders. Empathy is at the heart of excellence in clinical care and all health and human services fields. Many stories from this graduating class reflected this important value, and it left us with an enormous sense of inspiration by what you have and what you will accomplish in the years to come. So in closing, class of 2023, although you may be graduating from Long Beach State University, we will always be with you. Take pride in this moment and enjoy this achievement. You have earned it. Remember that your voice and talent matters. Always stand up for what you believe in. And remember that no action is too small or an obstacle too big. No barriers ever. Go Beach. Every year, the college selects an undergraduate and graduate student to receive the Outstanding Graduate Award. Please welcome to the podium Dr. Grace Reynolds-Fisher, Associate Dean for Faculty Affairs and Research, who will introduce our graduate student awardee.
It is my pleasure to introduce Kylie Godey, this year's Outstanding Graduate Student Award winner. In her 2 years as a graduate student at Cal State Long Beach, Kylie has been immersing herself in an incredible variety of curriculum and professional development activities, preparing her to enter the fast-paced, ever-changing healthcare industry as a well-rounded professional. Among her collegiate achievements, Kylie led a team of fellow Cal State Long Beach Master of Healthcare Administration candidates to a first place finish at the annual College Bowl hosted by the American College of Healthcare Executives. In addition to her outstanding achievement at the College Bowl, Kylie was honored to be appointed Vice Chair of Student Council for the American College of Healthcare Executives Southern California Chapter. Perhaps the most impressive is the highly competitive administrative fellowship Kylie has received from the City of Hope. Kylie will begin her fellowship in July 2023, offering her outstanding industry experience. Dr. Jeffrey Helton, a lecturer in the Department of Healthcare Administration, says of Kylie, "Kylie is a witty and intelligent young executive with a strong grasp of the business elements of our healthcare industry. She is soon to be the star of a leading healthcare organization. Please welcome our CHHS outstanding graduate, Kylie Godey."
Hi, good afternoon, fellow graduates, faculty, family, friends, and loved ones. I'm so humbled by the opportunity to join you here today and share a few words on a day of such exciting achievement. My dad has always loved reminding me that there's no such thing as luck. Growing up, instead of wishing me good luck, he would remind me instead of the consistency and hard work I had committed that would lead to a great outcome. He said, "It's not about luck, it's about preparation." And that advice and perspective came to really shape my own views to this day. Then, while preparing for this speech, I happened to come across a quote from a Roman philosopher stating, "Luck is what happens when preparation meets opportunity." So ultimately, I guess I owe that perspective to Seneca, but thanks, Dad, nice try. I spent some time recently reflecting on the preparation and opportunities that brought me here today, and repeatedly found myself coming back to another key piece of that equation, which is the people. I spent that time thinking about how I could speak endlessly to the guidance, mentorship, and support that I've received and grown because of throughout my life and in my career thus far. Whether it was from family, friends, teammates, coaches, professors, the list really goes on. But I find myself continuously surrounded by individuals who inspire, uplift, and challenge me in everything that I do. And just as those people have shaped my personal journey, my own wish to be impactful in the lives of others is what first drew me to a career in healthcare. Although I definitely started out with a very different vision of what that path was going to look like for me. I repeatedly failed to achieve the goals with the approach that I had set my sights firmly on, which was really difficult at the time. But over time, in no small part thanks to my support system, I came to realize that what I perceived to be failure in the moment continuously reveals itself to be a blessing in disguise. Every time I fail, it simply becomes a stepping stone on a route that I hadn't really pictured yet. During my first year of my program, I sought career advice from one of my mentors and professors. His response really stuck with me and has helped shift my perception of the inevitable ups and downs that life has in store for me. He told me to stop trying to figure out what I want to be when I grow up, because most people will work their entire lives and still not know. Not only was that advice incredibly freeing, but it helped me change the way that I approach goal setting. I now place more value on my ability to be adaptable and roll with the punches as they come, and less on sticking to a rigid, detailed, multi-step outline that I create for myself, although that's admittedly been a tough habit to break, and I'm still definitely a work in progress. I'm truly so grateful for my colleagues, professors, and all of the staff in the faculty in the Department of Healthcare Administration who've played such an important role in helping me turn the perceived failures that brought me to this master's program into one of the best decisions that I've ever made. Thanks to them, I have no doubt that my original intention of pursuing a career that puts helping others at the forefront will be fulfilled, even if I can't map that exact path out in advance right now. I know that all of the preparation and hard work that this graduating class has committed is about to meet a world ripe with opportunity. And if I didn't know better, I would conclude by wishing you all the best of luck in your future endeavors. However, I'll instead encourage you to be so proud of yourselves, where your hard work has taken you so far, and to be confident in where it's going to lead you next. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.
Congratulations, Kylie. The online commencement program provides a list of distinguished academic awards and their recipients. Congratulations to all awardees. Will all the students who received any one of these distinguished honors and awards please stand and be recognized? It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Kurt Brower, the president of CSULB Alumni Council. Mr. Brower will make a few remarks on behalf of the Alumni Association. Mr. Brower received his master's in public administration from Long Beach State University in 2000 and is a proud parent of a Presidential Scholar alum from the class of 2015 from the College of Engineering. Kurt has been with the city of Newport Beach for over 30 years and currently serves as senior buyer for the city. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Brower to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Lounsbury, and congratulations to the class of 2023. It is truly an honor to be here with you today. As a Beach alum, an alumni parent, and a fellow human just trying to navigate our complicated world, I have a sense of what it took for all of you to get here. What you've accomplished is nothing short of extraordinary. And because it's been a number of years since my own graduation, I can also say with some certainty that your time at the beach has shaped your futures in more ways than you could have ever imagined. But you will discover that for yourselves in good time. For now, just know that as you receive your degrees today, you become a part of an impressive and influential alumni community that is more than 365,000 members strong. These people, these previous generations of alumni, helped enrich your college experience, and I hope that when you are able, you will share your time and talents with the students who now come after you. I want to personally thank all of you who have already made your first financial contribution to the university as alums as part of the 2023 class gift. I encourage you to stay connected to your alma mater in the ways that are most meaningful and rewarding to you. Fortunately, that's easier to do and much more enjoyable now that we have the extraordinary Anna W. Nye Alumni Center to come back to. Once again, on behalf of CSULB alumni, I would like to congratulate all of you, as well as your family and friends, on this truly incredible accomplishment. And remember, you will always have a home at the beach. As we like to say, the beach is for life. Thank you, go beach, and go class of 2023.
Graduates and guests, please welcome the seventh president of the California State University Long Beach, Dr. Jane Close Connolly.
When I start thinking about what to say at commencement every year, the choices are endless because our campus is the source of countless stories, most of which were written or enhanced by you. 4 or more years at the beach. Many of you started in an analog world, in which only about 4% of our classes were taught remotely, and you've lived through a period when only about 4% of our classes were taught in person. What a turnaround. But yet you are here because of your resilience and because of your supportive faculty and staff. You've seen it all. Thanks for sticking it out together. I can only imagine that there were times when you thought about throwing it all away because your internet didn't work, or that remote classes did not engage, or that not coming to campus opened up other possibilities for you. Sticking with us has also allowed you to fuel some pretty amazing beach facts. The Shikarian Student Success Center, including the Bob Murphy Access Center, was completed just as some of you were arriving, and it has flourished in its mission because of all of you who have shared and contributed your growing professional skills to students seeking services. Because of you, Cal State Long Beach is ranked number 7 in the nation for awarding bachelor's degrees, and number 13 nationally in awarding master's degrees to Latinx students. We've been promoted from a master's level to a doctoral level high-intensity research university because some of you chose us for doctoral work, and many of you worked in faculty research labs. I share these with you to congratulate you for being part of building this great university. You are all the recipients of or forces behind these accolades. You all, like those before you, have been building a better beach for 74 years. And it's been noticed, as we have the most undergraduate applications among the CSUs and are ranked about 8th nationally in applications. So as you begin your next adventures, remember we're grateful to all you have all you've done in supporting our continuous improvement. Students, I pledge that your alma mater will keep innovating as a way to add value to your degrees. We also pledge to be rooted in our values that are also perhaps yours. Diversity is our strength. The public good is our responsibility. Teaching, learning, and discovery are central to who we are and all we do. And finally, compassion, creativity, and innovation characterize our culture. If we can continue to live by those values, you will be proud to call us your alma mater. In the same way, we're so proud of all that you've already accomplished and all we know you will create for the world. All good wishes on all your next adventures, and go Beach.
Thank you, President Conley. And now, the moment you have been waiting for. It is time to confer degrees. To begin, I'm delighted to invite our Provost and Senior Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. Karen Sissom-Gunn, to the podium to recognize our doctoral candidates for graduation.
Thank you, Dean Lounsbury, and good afternoon, Beach family and friends. Let's make it official. Today, I have the distinct honor of announcing graduate candidate degrees for the class of 2023. At this time, will all candidates for the Doctor of Nursing Practice and the Doctor of Physical Therapy please stand if you're able and remain standing. President Connolly, these candidates have satisfactorily completed all degree requirements and have been approved by the faculty of the College of Health and Human Services to receive their degrees. Congratulations, go you, and go Beach!
Doctoral candidates, You have been recommended to me by the Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, and by your Dean, and by your distinguished faculty. Therefore, by the authority vested in me by the Chancellor and the Board of Trustees of California State University, I confer upon each of you who has fulfilled all requirements the appropriate doctoral degree with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations. You may be seated.
I will now present the candidates for the master's degree. Will candidates for the master's degree please stand at this time if you're able and remain standing? President Connolly, these candidates have satisfactorily completed all requirements for the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Science, and Master of Public Health, and have been approved by the faculty of the College of Health and Human Services to receive their degrees. Congratulations to you, go you, and go Beach.
Master's candidates, you have been recommended to me by the Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, and by your Dean, and by your distinguished faculty. Therefore, by the authority vested in me by the Chancellor and the Board of Trustees of the California State University, I confer upon each of you who has fulfilled all requirements the appropriate master's degree with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations. You may be seated.
And now, the bachelor's candidates. Will the candidates for bachelor's degree please stand? President Connolly, these candidates have satisfactorily completed all of the requirements for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science and have been approved by the faculty of the College of Health and Human Services to receive their degrees.
Bachelor's candidates, you have been recommended to me by the Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs and by your Dean and by your distinguished faculty. Therefore, by the authority vested in me by the Chancellor and the Board of Trustees of the California State University, I confer upon each of you who has fulfilled all requirements the appropriate bachelor's degree with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Graduates, you may now move your tassel to the left side of your cap. This signifies the completion of your undergraduate degree. Congratulations, and you may be seated.
Although your graduation ceremony has ended, your relationship and connection with Long Beach State University has not. For your lifetime, you will always be part of the beach. You will also be ambassadors and representatives of this great university. Wherever you go, the College of Health and Human Services and Long Beach State University are with you. Congratulations to the class of 2023, and go Beach!
Thank you.
Graduates and guests, thank you for joining us this afternoon for the commencement ceremony for the College of Health and Human Services. We invite you to please make your way out to meet your graduate at one of our 6 graduate recognition stages just outside our stadium gates. There, graduates and family can view their graduate slide and hear their names read as they cross the stage. Congratulations and go Beach!